thank you everybody for watching this video. Push the like button, leave a comment, subscribe, and push that notification bell. It will help us tremendously to grow this channel. We have a bunch of stuff coming out for you, the fans, unique content, so please stay tuned. All right, JHK here for the All-Star, and join me right now is UFC lightweight, Matt Sayles. Am I correct? You're coming back at lightweight?
Yeah, I'm making a quick pit stop. I got pretty heavy with the time off, having a baby and then ACL surgery. So with that time off, I got pretty fat, bro. I hit like 250 pounds. Coming down, we thought it was a better idea to stop at 55 and then take a fighter or two, see how it goes, and then go back down. Get back to work at 45.
There's a lot to dissect right there, man. You mentioned so much because you've been out for almost pretty much 2 years, man. The last time we saw you was in December 2019. After the Bryce Mitchell fight, where was the mind at for you?
I was pretty defeated, bro. That fucking sucked. I'd never been finished. I had lost before. But, you know, two split decisions, real close ones, many I probably won. But that was my first time being finished and like taking a loss. It really fucking sucked, especially being the way it was, you know, the second twister in UFC history. And it took a while to come back. I saw a sports psychologist for a little bit, and I had to work through a lot. But I've coming from that, I've transformed, you know, like I don't think the same way anymore. I'm a whole different person. And I had my daughter after that, so that just completely changed me. And something I don't really think about anymore. It's become like the meme of my career so far, but I've just accepted it and moving forward.
Yeah, was the sports psychologist did they have a big effect on you with that?
I decided to try it. You know, I spoke to my manager and I'm like, dude, I don't feel good. You know, like I want to talk to somebody. We tried it. I think I did four, maybe five sessions, like 30-minute sessions. And the biggest thing was, like breathing exercise he showed me, and you know a lot of what he said I kind of already knew, you know, deep in my mind, you know, I should have known this stuff. He just kind of was like the oh yeah type reaction, and he just kind of opened my eyes to certain things, and I worked through it myself, you know. It wasn't something that I think I'll ever need again, but I had a good try.
Yeah, definitely, man. You got to try everything, right? At this level, it's the highest level.
For sure, exactly. So I thought I would, and I got something out of it. So
yeah, for sure. You know, and you mentioned the birth of your daughter, man. That, you know, I have a daughter myself. She's 10, so I could relate to you, man. It does change you. How has it changed you in the last couple of years?
Well, she's turned 10 months today, so it's been crazy, dude. It happened really fast. I love her to death, and I just want to give her everything that I didn't have growing up. You know, so I really want to go out there, want to put in a big performance, I want to knock this guy out. I want to get a bonus and you know, put some food in her, give her some good food, get her new places to, you know, to live her own room. I want to provide for her. It's changed me a lot. Like there's a whole new sense of drive and pride to me, and I want to show the new me, you know, the new mature Matt.
You said you had the injury, right? When did that exactly happen?
During COVID, right before the lockdown, I was training to Gordon. I was coming back, and I blew out my ACL the first time, my first sparring for that camp. So that's what happened. I blew out my ACL. My meniscus also tore, so they replaced the ACL, repaired the meniscus, and like a 6 month long recovery before I could really do much. And then from there, just mental battles, and then, you know, the weight gain, and now I've dropped the weight and ready to get back. So I just accepted everything for what it was and then moving on. You know, the injury is just another thing.
Was the recovery physically, was it pretty easy when you came back?
Yeah, it wasn't too bad, other than just getting out of shape. You know, like I said, I put on a bunch of weight, so when I had to get back running and stuff, it was hard. And then the muscle atrophy, my leg had no muscle, so rebuilding that was tough. But I'm used to working hard, so the physical therapy is somewhat easy. It felt boring at times, but I got it all done, and I'm back.
Man, dropping that weight—you said 250 pounds—and you're coming back at 155. That's just doing that is an accomplishment in life, man.
I know. Yeah, I feel good. Like, I'm seeing a six pack again. Like, I see, like, abs and muscles in my life. It feels good, you know. So, look good, feel good, you know. So, I just can't wait to get in there and show off, like, this new, you know. So, used to being fat for a while. I knew I was getting counted out just coming off that loss, the injury, being so fat. People are looking at me. This guy can't make it happen. But, you know, I'm savage, so I can't.
Yeah, for sure. Let's talk about this fight coming up, December 18th versus Jordan Leavitt. You know, what is your breakdown of him? He's kind of he's very unorthodox, let's say.
Yeah. You know, I did an interview before, and I was telling him, like, I think he's unorthodox because his striking isn't all there. He doesn't have the boxing. His kickboxing is really, it seems random. Like, he's just throwing things out there to close that gap and get, you know, a body lock or a dive on the leg, something like that. So when I look at him, I don't see a great fighter. I see a one-dimensional. I'm sure he's the same about me. You know, my grappler, but he's in for a surprise. I see, like, high school level wrestling. The striking's not there. Like, I can teach a kid to do better. So I just want to go out there, stop the takedown, show my improvement on the wrestling and the ground. I'm not gonna take him down. No way he's going to be able to do anything. The improvement I've made in these 2 years off, especially coming off that submission loss, the jump, the leaps and bounds in jiu-jitsu. So it's just going to be a bad night for him, man. I see me just keeping him on the feet and picking him apart.
The leaps and bounds before you got into this camp, right, to focus on Jordan, what did you work on, you know, besides, like, lowering the weight?
Oh, dude, jiu-jitsu, like, positions after position, having guys on my back, nonstop, just putting myself through the worst positions, the worst rounds, you know, fresh bodies every round, just pushed me. A lot of training partners came and go. Came and went, I'm sorry. And, that's really what I focused on. And then the boxing was always there. We always do that. So it'd be, you know, morning jiu-jitsu or wrestling, and then sharpen up the hands at night. So every day I worked on that plane. So, you know, I can't even explain the difference in the jiu-jitsu. I just want to show it. And I might even let him take me down just to show jiu-jitsu. So that's our confidence.
When you have that weight on you and then you, you know, drop it off, it's all gone. Do you feel faster?
I do. And I still feel like I kept a lot of that power. Like, I look at myself, my upper body just doesn't look the same. Because when I fought at 45, you know, my body's completely different, like a bodybuilder, bulk and shred, you know. Bulk. So I put on some muscle. I've kept the power. I felt that weight. You know, it was like wearing a weighted vest for almost a year. It's like I feel fast. Like, my calves are different. Everything's different. It's just, I feel like I said, a brand new fighter, brand new person. My whole mentality is different. It's all going to show. There's only so much I can say. It's going to show in this fight.
You're going to go to the weigh-ins and people will be like, damn, what? This is a new guy. Like, we didn't recognize this.
I ain't on steroids, but I mean, I'm going to look good compared to 250, man.
Yeah, but, I feel you.
It's going to be good. I'm going to perform well.
Yeah, man. I'm glad to see you coming back, man. End of this year. What is your expectations for the next year? You know, 2022, I'm pretty sure you want to stay super busy because you missed 2 years of your career.
Yeah. I'm getting older. I'm not old. I'm 27. I'm going to turn 28. I want to really, like, I got a few years in this sport. I'll give myself, make something happen, something big. So I just want to fight after, like, back to back to back. So hopefully I put this guy out. If I don't, just come out, you know, my hands okay, not injured. Get a quick turnaround and come back again and fight again and hopefully build some highlight reels and move up in competition, so on, make some money, and see what happens, you know, see my options.
Yeah, definitely, man. You do got the skill set to line up some highlight reels, and I'm excited to see the new version of you, man. So when you do come back, you'll be at featherweight, right?
Yes, for sure. Like, well, this one's, like I said, pit stopping, but when I'm, like, in it to, you know, go for any gold or anything like that, if I can make that happen, I'm sure I'll be fine.
No, well, I'm excited, man. December 18th, UFC Fight Night, Las Vegas. Matt, appreciate the time, man. Good luck on the fight, and enjoy the holidays, man. The first ones with your baby, right?
Yeah. First Christmas.
Yeah, that's going to be awesome, man.
Yeah, I can't wait, man. Thank you.